So sometimes going on a fast has the potential to lower a thyroid hormone called T3, and that's the active form of the thyroid hormone. T4 is the inactive version. So I want to explain why that is. We have the pituitary up here that communicates to the thyroid through this hormone called thyroid stimulating hormone. And one of the main ways that hypothyroidism is diagnosed is by looking at this hormone right here. But when you fast through the ketogenic diet and do it healthily, you're not going to see a change in this hormone right here. So you are not going to have a true hypothyroid condition or problem. Then the thyroid releases T4, which is the inactive form of the thyroid hormone. To become activated, it has to work through the liver into the kidney, but it converts from T4 to T3, and T3 is the active form of the thyroid hormone. But there's something else over here called reverse T3. And the difference between T3 and reverse T3 is that T3 is active and reverse T3 is an inactive version. Now, I'm not going to get into the technical part of this, but I just simply want to tell you that what determines the rate and ratio of this conversion to T3 or reverse T3 is the metabolic need, because this has to do with preserving energy. When you do a fast, you may see a slight decrease in T3, and many times it'll still be within the normal range, but you're going to see an increase in the reverse T3. Your body is simply becoming more efficient with its fuel. So the need for the active thyroid hormone is going to be a little bit less. The body will then put some of that hormone into a little bit of a reserve until you need it. And it'll be released once you are refeeding and you eat again. There's several situations where you'll see higher amounts of reverse T3. When you're doing fasting, or when you're recovering from a stroke or an injury, or overtraining when you're exercising, or when you're recovering from an illness or surgery, or when you just have lost a good amount of weight, reverse T3 will go up. One thing I want to show you is T4 usually represents 90% of all the thyroid hormones. T3 will represent about 9% of all the thyroid hormones, and reverse T3 usually represents about 0.9%. There's a very small amount of hormones, it's like 0.1, that is designated for something else, because fasting slows the conversion from T4 to T3, so it just dumps out over here. It's not a disease state. You're still going to feel fine. You're still going to lose weight. You're not going to have any of the symptoms. But I think it's important for you to know what's happening sometimes to certain people when they do a fast as it relates to the thyroid. Thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.